Hello, Deployment Insiders. Welcome back to another episode with the Ranger team. So my name is Martin, and with me is Bob.
Hey, everyone. Welcome back for another video.
And we would like to cover a new topic, a new feature in the Apps Admin Center. So what do we have on tap today, Bob?
Yeah, so in today's video, we're going to be exploring a capability that we recently added to servicing profiles in the Microsoft 365 Apps Admin Center. So this capability we've given the code name of Start Small, but essentially it's Azure AD group support for servicing profiles. So if you're working with a servicing profile and you're going through your device selection criteria, there's a number of existing filters there, but now you have the capability of targeting an Azure AD group. We think this is a fantastic capability because it allows you to start with a smaller set of users or devices as you evaluate these capabilities and check out the benefits for monthly enterprise channel. So we're going to be exploring Start Small in detail. We're going to jump into a demo tenant and check out the feature and show you how it works. And then we'll talk about tips, tricks, and use cases that you can leverage in your environment as you start working with these configurations.
Sounds great. So in case servicing profile is not ringing in a bell, it's a cloud enabled update management that you can use in the Apps Admin Center. It works on a tenant level. But without Start Small, the existing controls might be too broad for you. Usually we use the update channel selector to specify which devices should be treated as in scope. And then servicing profile will convert all these devices over to the monthly enterprise channel and keep them updated automatically. But maybe that's too broad. So Start Small can help here. Bob, can you show us how it works?
Yeah, definitely. So let's jump into a demo and get a closer look at how this works. So here I am signed into the Microsoft 365 Apps Admin Center. The account I'm using has the Office Apps Admin role, which gives me the capability to access servicing profiles and administer all these features. I've already navigated to Servicing Monthly Enterprise, and I'm looking at the Settings tab. Now, if this is your first time working with a servicing profile, you'll be presented with something called the First Time Run Experience. It will have you walk through device selection criteria, but then after that point, if you need to make modifications, you'll go through this way. So here I am, I'm gonna make some edits to my profile. Right off the bat, we have a number of filtering options. The first one's groups, which we're gonna talk about in more detail, but by default, it's set to include all devices. Then you have channels, disk space, macros, and add-ins. As an admin, you can alter these settings to further dial in what devices you want picked up by the servicing profile. Now, the feature we're here to talk about is Azure AD group support. So I'm gonna choose this radio button, choose groups to include, which has the preview tag next to it because we are still in public preview at the time of this recording. Once that's selected, you can choose the add group to list button and then search Azure AD for a group that you want to target. In this case, I have a pilot group for servicing profiles. It's got three objects in there, so I'm going to add that to my list. That's reflected here in the UI. I can add additional groups if I want to, and I can also remove groups if I want to retire them from the profile. Be aware that if you remove all of your groups and you hit save, it will default back to include all devices. That will be the next filtering option up. Once a group is applied, the rest of these filters will be applied based on the objects in that group. So, for example, I have three objects currently in my group, and of those three, how many are on monthly enterprise channel, how many have 5 gigs of disk space free, how many have macros, so on and so forth. Now, if I want to, let's say I have some devices in this group that are on semi-annual enterprise channel and I want to make sure they get picked up by the servicing profile, I'm going to go ahead and check the box for semi-annual enterprise channel. So of those three, any that are on that channel will get picked up and moved over to servicing profiles. All right, with these settings, I think I'm happy to move forward. I'm going to go ahead and click save to apply my changes. At which point, shortly thereafter, you should see the device chart over here on the right update as it did just now. And maybe within an hour or two, if you go to the devices tab, you'll see the devices there reflect the changes that you have applied to your servicing profile.
I have a question for you. So if I'm an admin and I'm changing something here, or I'm adding devices to the group, what is the time frame that I should expect, the time that must pass before I can see the change in a profile?
Yeah, that's a great question, Martin. So there's really two time frames that an admin needs to be aware of. So if we're looking back at the group that I selected, The first group I put in there had three objects in it. Now, if an admin on the back end goes into Azure AD and adds five more objects in there, that type of change gets reevaluated every 24 hours. So there will be some delay for that to be reflected in the servicing profile. The other time frame to be aware of is if there's a service side change. So basically, if that admin, instead of adding five members to that existing group, came in here and added an entirely new group with five members, or maybe changed some of the selection criteria in the profile and applied those changes, those would be applied within 1 to 2 hours. And you should see those reflected again in the devices list as well as the device chart once applied.
Okay, sounds great. One question, you edit users. Most admins are syncing along the lines of devices. Can I also use devices? And for example, I have devices grouped in my configuration manager nicely into different collections. Is there a way to bring this here into the servicing profile?
That's another great call out, Martin. So if you're just getting started with servicing profiles and you have a set of test devices or virtual machines that you'd like to get started with, you can add them to an Azure AD group and then target them with the servicing profile. The only requirement there is that those devices be either Azure AD joined or hybrid Azure AD joined. If they don't meet that requirement, then the servicing profile won't be able to pick them up. Now, alternatively, you can add user objects to these groups and we can target them as well. In that case, we look up the user information from what we know in inventory. So the endpoints themselves are the devices. We don't care about the domain join relationship. The devices could be Azure AD registered. They could be workgroup computers. We're just going to leverage the license and activation information there.
And can I reuse collections I have in Config Manager in any way?
Yeah, absolutely. So if you have Configuration Manager in your environment today and you've already created collections for Microsoft 365 apps, you can turn on a feature called Tenant Attach and then enable collection synchronization with Azure AD security groups. This gives you the ability to target specific collections and replicate them into Azure AD groups, at which point now you can go into servicing profiles and pick those groups and save yourself a lot of time. I guess, Martin, in the same context, if you're using Azure AD Connect to synchronize objects between on-prem AD and Azure AD, what's the outcome there in terms of servicing profiles?
Great question. So at the end, to be honest, it doesn't matter. The servicing profile is reading the information from the Azure AD group. How the members were added to the group is not relevant. So if it's a synchronized group coming from your Active Directory, or if it is a group which is synchronized using Config Manager, or it was created by bulk importing a CSV file, or just a manually created group where someone is managing the members every day in a manual way. At the end, it doesn't matter. If it is an Azure AD group, we can consume this group in the servicing profile.
Ah, that's perfect. Well, we are super excited to have Azure AD group support available in the portal, and we have a lot of new capabilities and enhancements coming down the road. So be sure to click subscribe so you get notified when we put out new videos and announcements. Also, as you're using these features in the portal, check out the feedback button. Please submit your feedback, positive or negative. If you want to hear back from us, include your email address. That goes directly to the dev team, and we love hearing your feedback. We also have a presence over on the Microsoft Tech Community site. Myself and the other Rangers post blogs out there both about Office and the Apps Admin Center. And the discussion forums are filled with great community members around the world sharing their feedback and their experiences. Until next time, keep on deploying.